My name is Jason Kwan, and I am an assistant professor at the Division of Pharmaceutical Sciences at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. In this video, I will be talking about our latest paper in M-Systems, Increased Biosynthetic Gene Dosage in a Genome-Reduced Defensive Bacterial Symbiont. Bacteria have provided us with many small molecules that we use as drugs for lots of different diseases, such as bacterial infection and cancer. However, it is thought that the vast majority of bacteria cannot be cultured in the laboratory, meaning that we could be missing out on potentially useful drug molecules made by unculturable species. For instance, many bioactive compounds, including the anti-cancer drug Yondelis, are made by symbiotic bacteria that live inside marine invertebrates. These small molecules likely act as a chemical defense against grazing animals for the host invertebrates, which can't move or otherwise defend themselves. Defensive symbionts are therefore a great place to look for bioactive small molecules, except that they often undergo a process of genome reduction, which makes their culture difficult. When a microbe exclusively lives inside a eukaryotic host, a constant supply of nutrients reduces the need for many biochemical pathways and regulatory mechanisms, and over time, these functions are lost due to weak selective pressure to keep them. Through this process, symbionts become less able to live outside their host, and their small, isolated populations make it impossible to gain back functions through horizontal gene transfer. We and others have found examples of genome-reduced symbionts that make bioactive small molecules. And although in the majority of bacteria, the biosynthetic pathways that make such small molecules are clustered, in symbionts, they tend to be fragmented around the genome. In our present work, we investigated the biosynthesis of potent cytotoxic molecules called the mandelolides that were isolated from a marine tunicate living off the coast of South Africa. Through shotgun metagenomic sequencing, we assembled the genome of a bacterial symbiont of this tunicate, and this contains a complex polyketide synthase pathway that fits very well with the mandelolide structures. We can tell that the symbiont is currently undergoing genome reduction because many of its genes are truncated compared to its closest known relative, and it also possesses far fewer genes. However, the pathway for the mandelolides is repeated 7 times in the genome, demonstrating that despite the overall drive for reduction, there is strong selection pressure to maximize mandelolides production. The symbiont has lost the capacity for homologous recombination, and the repeats have diverged somewhat from each other, so it appears as if the pathway is not a recent horizontal transfer. What we expect to happen in the future evolution of this symbiont is that deleterious mutations will accumulate over time due to frequent population bottlenecks, until individual gene copies become non-functional pseudogenes and can be deleted. One can imagine that such a process could eventually result in the fragmented pathways that we see in other symbionts that are in an advanced state of genome reduction. Therefore, the mandelolides-producing symbiont, which we call Candidatus didademnitutus mandela, could represent the ancestral state of other small molecule-producing symbionts, where strong selection promoted pathway duplication at the beginning of the symbiosis for higher gene dosage and production, followed by progressive sequence degradation, leading to one fragmented pathway.